Hello and welcome to Behind the Bar with me, Cara Devine. We recently had a comment from a viewer called Ares Creed about my preference for stirring all booze drinks. I know this is something that many of you have wondered about, and judging by many of the comments, it's a thorny debate when it comes to martinis. But what does shaking or stirring actually do to your drink? Is there a rule of thumb that tells you which to use? Well, let's take a quick look at the science and effects of each one. The very first serious bar I worked in actually had their cocktail list divided into shaken and stirred drinks, which of course led me to ask why. It seemed like an arbitrary distinction to a newbie like me. Surely you wanted to give the guests an idea of what the drink would be like, and just naming the technique used doesn't really give you that, does it? The answer that I got was that it actually kind of does. The aim of both stirring and shaking is to chill and dilute the drink. Shaking, though, does this much faster and has the added effect of changing the texture. Dave Arnold, whose book Liquid Intelligence is a must for any science-minded bartender, calculated that shaking is so violent that after around 15 seconds, the drink reaches an equilibrium of chilling and diluting, i.e. it won't do much of either, even if you continue to shake. Stirring, on the other hand, is quite inefficient and would take closer to 2 minutes to reach the same point of equilibrium, which, let's face it, is much longer than people usually stir for. So, stirring a drink actually means it will be less cold and less diluted than a shaken drink. This might not sound particularly desirable, but we're obviously not saying the drink will be warm here. It will still be chilled, but just slightly less so, and that means that the nuances of the ingredients will be a bit more perceptible. 9 times out of 10, if I'm using a special bottle in a cocktail, I'll do so in a stirred drink, for instance when I used Redbreast 15-year-old in the Tipperary cocktail. Stirring also gives you much more control, so you can choose, for instance, if you're serving something on ice, to stir it a little bit less and it's not as diluted when being served and will last a little longer in the serving glass. The flip side to this element of control is that stirred drinks do take more care and attention. And Arnold also proved that the quality and size of ice used doesn't make too much of a difference in shaking, whereas it really does with stirred drinks, so use decent ice and plenty of it. Of course, this is not the only difference. We need to talk about the big one, and that's texture. Shaking chills and dilutes, but it also aerates and emulsifies, so it creates air bubbles in the drink and ensures that all of the ingredients are properly combined. An easy way of seeing this is to look at a sour with egg white. I don't think you'd be very happy getting a stirred down one with big glops of the white in there. And this is really where the bartender rule of thumb comes in. If a drink only contains booze and sugar, it can be stirred because the texture will be smooth and silky, which is ideal for showcasing a spirit-forward drink. But if it contains anything else like juice, dairy, or coffee, it should be shaken to take advantage of that aeration and produce a light and airy drink. So you can kind of see where the difference comes in that menu split before. You can see this most clearly when using something like pineapple juice or coffee, which actually produces a fluffy head on the drink. But even a well-shaken drink with citrus should have a little halo of bubbles promising extreme refreshment. So now you know, and armed with this knowledge, you can head off and do whatever you like to your martini. In other exciting news, we're working on new designs for Behind the Bar merch, so keep your eyes out, lots of fun coming soon. We'll put links in the description as soon as it's ready.